This is Jerry from ET Figure Unboxing, and in this video, we're going to take a look at Figma number 301, Orihara Izaya from Durarara 2. And as you guys can see, I do have both versions over here, but we're just going to take a look at a regular one because they're exactly the same. Let me just put this away. All right, so here's the left of the box, here is the right of the box, and here's the back of the box, and it looks really good. Let's not waste any more time and bust this thing open and see what we got. All right, so here we have the figure still in their inner packaging, and he doesn't come with a whole lot, but I feel like they did give us what like the character needs. Knife, cell phone, pocket, two interchangeable faces. Maybe one more face will be nice, because they are a little bit expensive nowadays. Like, they retail at $50, and with shipping, it's like 60 or 70. But yeah, anyways, let's bust this thing open and check out the figure itself. All right, so here we have the figure itself, and on the bright side, he looks amazing. And in my opinion, this is well worth $50. Like, it does have that kind of quality. We gotta remember, we're paying for high-skilled labor for Max Factory because they hand paint all their figures. Like, this is very amazing. I love the matte finish. The color just looks nice. And let's check out the articulation and see what we got. Alright, so for the articulation, let's quickly go over it from the neck down. He can look up and down, no problem. He can turn his head, no problem. And the shoulder is on a regular like Figma ball joint, and you can swivel over there. And you can also swivel on the bicep as well, so that's really nice. And the wrist is on a ball joint like usual. And he does have a pretty good ab crunch, even though it doesn't seem like it. All these are on softer material, including the jacket. And the lower body, you can kick up around that much. And you can bend that much, and you do have a toe hinge. And these are just on a regular Figma joints. Yeah, so it's pretty standard. I'm pretty sure most of you are familiar with these. And let's check out the accessories. Right, so first off, we have the default face, which is kind of steering to the left, and that looks really nice. I love it. Next up, we have kind of like a shouting face, or you know, when he's talking to someone, and this is pretty cool. It looks exactly like him. And lastly, we have a gomenasai kind of face. It looks surprisingly good. I love it. Alright, so next up, he came with a pair of interchangeable arms that allows you to put the hands in the pocket, and these feels pretty good. Like, probably one of the better ones I have experienced. Like, this is very easy to assemble, but I usually don't like doing this because it wears down the joint over time. It gets a little bit loose, so you gotta be careful with that. But yeah, it looks amazing. I love it. I love it. Alright, so next up, he came with three pairs of hands, and one for holding the knife, one for normal holding hands, and just a pair of display open hands. And let's check out what it looks like. Alright, so first off, we have the pair of display open hands, and these are pretty standard. Almost every Figma has them nowadays. Alright, so next up, he came with a pair for him to hold the knife, and it's pretty cool. I love the detail on this one, and let's check out what that looks like. Alright, so here's the Izaya assembled with a knife, and it sits in there very nicely. I love it. Alright, so the last pair of hands is just regular Figma holding hands, and these are pretty standard, and that is pretty cool. Alright, so lastly, he came with a right hand that's holding a cell phone, and it's really nicely detailed, but it's just, you know, very plain. You can't really see anything on the screen, and yeah, that's pretty cool. And I don't think you can remove it, and let's jump straight into the size comparison. Alright, so first off, we have the Naruto figures, and they look very good. I do have reviews for every single one of them, so check them out if you haven't, and yeah, that looks pretty cool. Alright, so next up, we have the SH Figuarts Avengers figures, and they look really good as well. SH Figuarts Kamen Rider figures, SH Figuarts Star Wars figures, SH Figuarts Dragon Ball figures, some more random SH Figuarts. And finally, we got some Figma figures. More Figma figures. And it's always fun to do stuff like this, because they're using the same joints. Alright, so lastly, we have him standing next to Shizuo, and they look very good together. And let's jump straight into the final thoughts. Alright, so for the final thoughts, there's really nothing for me to say. If you like the character, you're gonna love the figure. But even if you don't like the character and don't know anything about the series, I still think it's a pretty good piece to have, because Figma always does a really good job for these anime characters, and this one is no exception. The paint work is nice, and the articulation is there. The accessories, I think they gave us just enough, no more, no less. But I still think overall it's a really good piece. But I'm a little bit biased because I do like the character a lot. But yeah, do let me know in the comments what you guys think about anime and this figure in general. And this is Eric. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.